Swapneel here, back with another video, and in this video I'm going to be unboxing and taking a closer look at the new entry-level smartphone from Xiaomi, the Redmi 6A. This has recently been launched in India by Xiaomi at a price point of about 6999, which is approximately 7000 rupees. And as far as the specifications are concerned, before unboxing, let me give you an overview of the box itself, and I'll also discuss about the specifications. As you can see, Redmi 6A branding on both the sides, and this is kind of like an orange or red color box. Redmi 6A branding here as well. On the back, we can see the specifications. It features a 5.45 inches 720p display, which is HD+. That means 18:9 aspect ratio. It also has the MediaTek Helio A22 quad-core processor, which is built upon 12 nanometer process, a 3000 mAh battery, and a 13 megapixel rear camera with face detection autofocus. It features LTE and everything, nano SIM plus expandable micro SD card. So it does feature three slots, and it's made in India. Anyways, the variant which I have here is the black colored variant with 2GB RAM and 16GB of internal storage. Let us go ahead and unbox it now and take a closer look. Plastic is now off, and here's a seal which we need to break. The box is very snug. So here is the Redmi 6A itself. We'll keep it to the side for a second and we'll take a look at what else do we have in the box. First up, we have some user manuals, the user guide. This says how to dispose the product and how to use it, some buttons and controls, and also about the SIM card tray. We also have our SAR documentation and warranty information. Apart from that, we also have our wall adapter, which is of 0.2 amp charger, 5 volt 1 amp charger. So not a fast charger, it's actually very slow. I would have liked if they would have included a 10 watt charger, but nonetheless they've included a 5 watt charger. And here we also have our micro USB cable, sadly no type C in this price range yet, and we also have our SIM ejector tool. So we'll keep all these three to the side and we'll take a closer look at the phone itself. So this is the Redmi 6A. Let me peel the plastic here. Also on the back, we have a piece of plastic. So this is the black variant right here. This is the black colored variant, 2GB RAM and 16GB of internal storage. So this has a 13 megapixel face detection autofocus capable camera with LED flash. On the bottom here we have speakers. On the bottom here we have the micro USB port and the microphone for audio during phone calls. On the top we have our headphone jack and a microphone. On the left hand side we have two trays. One is for two SIM cards and the other one is for our micro SD card. On the right hand side we have volume rockers and the power lock and unlock button. We don't have a fingerprint scanner here. And one more thing to note here is that the build here is of plastic and it's not metal. As we have seen with the Redmi 4A and the Redmi 5A before this. So this is basically a spiritual successor to the Redmi 4A and the Redmi 5A. I've already unboxed Redmi 4A on my channel, so if you're interested, hit the I button, you'll find a video. Well, let us go ahead and set it up. MIUI 9. I'll just quickly set it up. This feels really compact in the hand because it's just 5.45 inches with the bigger 18:9 aspect ratio. And given that it's plastic, it's actually very light. It's still setting up. skip all this. Phone has completed setup now, so we can have a look at the interface which the phone has to provide. So this is MIUI 9, fresh out of the box. We'll go into about the phone and look at the settings once. So as you can see, device name Redmi 6A, model number 6A, Android version 8.1 with security patch level of 1st August, and it's running on MIUI version 9.6. hopefully it'll get the MIUI version 10 very soon. And out of the 16 GB total storage which we have about 8.4 GB available for us. RAM is 2 GB. So yeah, there we go. And CPU is quad core max 2 GHz, which is the MediaTek A22, clocked at 2 GHz, of course, which is Cortex A53 cores. And well, let me give you an overview of MIUI itself if you don't already know. This does not have a app drawer as such. All the apps are stored and maintained on the desktop in multiple panes. And let's see if it has all the gestures which we have seen with the newer Xiaomi phones. Yep, we do have the gestures. So go to home screen, open recents and go back. These are the gestures which we can use. So if we swipe up, we can go home. If we swipe up from the bottom and pause, it opens the multitasking tray. And if we swipe from the left hand side, we can go back. So that is also present here and accounted for, which is really good at this price point that we are seeing features from higher end devices on budget end Xiaomi devices. So I took a couple of pictures around my flat. So this is the selfie which I took from the 5 MP front facing camera. As you can see, the detail levels aren't the best. It's a bit washed out. As you can see, this picture, it's kind of washed out on the edges. So there is that. I also took a couple of pictures from the rear facing 13 MP camera. So this was in complete low light. As you can see, not the best picture in the world, very grainy. This was also taken in low light, again very grainy, colors aren't really good. This was in well lit condition and the picture came out to be decent, I will say. Still again, the focus and the sharpness isn't there. And even this was taken from the back facing camera, and as you can see, the camera didn't focus properly this time. And again, it's kind of blurry. So from what I've seen and what I've used it for a couple of hours, what I can say is, seems to be a decent enough phone, at least from the surface. We'll have to use it more to comment. Well, that's about it guys for this video. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did so, feel free to hit the thumbs up button down below. And also don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow me on Facebook, Google Plus and Twitter. Links to all of them are in the description.